Thank you, Madam President. Mr. Special Rapporteur, thank you for your work to insist that freedom of expression is critical to empowering individuals and communities. Your report addresses threats to journalism, including disabling independent journalists and failing to release those subject to arbitrary and unlawful detention, such as Shon Xiaoxer and Huang Shi. You also specifically cite the Chinese government's moves to silence and expel foreign journalists. Your report makes clear the need for continuous monitoring of restrictions on free expression. This would be a role for Chinese lawyers, but they too have been silenced. This week marked 5 years since the beginning of the so-called 709 crackdown, which targeted more than 300 lawyers and legal activists. Although most have been released, including Wan Chou in Jiang, the repression continues. Lawyer Yeo Wencheng was convicted in a secret trial in 2019, news his wife received just last month. The Chinese authorities also use more subtle tactics, including sanctioning speech by lawyers with disbarment, harassing family members and colleagues, and restricting access to family and to legal counsel. ISHR and its partners have previously submitted information to the mandate on these issues. Mr. Special Rapporteur, in light of limits to open and independent media in China and targeting of lawyers, what steps would you recommend the international community and specifically this council take to obtain credible, actionable information on the human rights situation in China, including Uyghur and Tibetan regions and Hong Kong? Thank you.